Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org, and today I will show you how to extend Hibernate Envers standard revision. That allows you, for example, to store the name of the user who performed the operation. If you're not familiar with Hibernate Envers, please take a look at the previous videos of this series. They show you how to add Hibernate Envers to your project so that it automatically writes your audit log, and how to use the Query API to search in the audit information. You can find a link to both videos in the video description. Hibernate Envers provides an easy way to write an audit log, but for most applications, some important information is missing in the default audit log. Hibernate Envers audits what had happened, but not who did it. The default revision entity doesn't store any information about the user who performed the operation. If you also want to store user information, like the username or IP address, you have to use a custom revision entity. Doing that is pretty simple. You just need to implement two classes to create and register a custom revision entity. The revision entity itself and a revision listener. Let's get into the IDE and take a look at the implementation. And make sure to watch until the end of this video when I tell you how to get the free cheat sheet in which I summarized the most important information. The easiest way to implement your own revision entity is to extend the default revision entity as I do in this example. If you don't want to do that, your entity needs to have at least two attributes. A revision number of type integer or long, annotated with revision number, and a revision timestamp of type long or Java util date, annotated with revision timestamp. I prefer to extend the default revision entity and just add a username attribute to my revision entity. And you also need to annotate your revision entity with a revision entity annotation and provide an implementation of the revision listener interface as a parameter. The implementation of the revision listener interface is the second class you need to implement. It tells Hibernate Envers how to set the attributes of the revision entity. The implementation of that interface isn't complicated. You just need to implement the newRevision method, which gets the newly instantiated revision entity as a parameter. Within this method, you have to set the values for all additional attributes of your revision entity. In this example, I just need to set the username attribute. I don't show the code of the getUsername method here, because it's specific to your technology stack. And to be honest, in this example, it just returns a static string. But Spring and all Java EE application server provide a way to get the current user. Please check your documentation to learn more about it and use it to implement the getUsername method. That's all you have to do to create and register your custom revision entity. When I now run this test case and persist a new author entity, Envers will use the custom revision and store the revision ID, timestamp, and username in the database. Here you can see the SQL insert statement and the three bind parameter values. So, we successfully implemented a custom revision that documents the name of the user who performed the operation. And you cannot only store this information in your audit log, you can also use it in your queries. As I showed you in the previous video, Hibernate Envers provides you with a powerful API that allows you to look at your log from a horizontal or vertical perspective. And when you create your audit query, you can reference the attributes of the revision entity by providing the attribute name to the revision property method. Here you can see an example that selects the numbers of all revisions, in which a user with the username user1 created, updated, or deleted a book entity. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!